The goal of neuroscience research is to understand how the brain works, and one of the major functions of the brain in human and animals is to control movement. Thus, it is an important field of study to look at motor behavior as the output of neural processing. Indeed, we move all the time. We make more eye movements than our heart beats. We walk, we grab utensils, we manipulate objects, we carry items, and so on. Speech also is a motor task. Virtually anything we do involves a motor task. And even abstract tasks, such as counting, are at least in part dependent on motor representations. So to study movement control, we use the fact that the nervous system continuously receives sensory information about the environment and transforms it into motor commands. It is a biological feedback control system. This in the lab, we apply perturbations to the environment or to the limb and measure corrective movements following these perturbations. Mechanical perturbations play a central role in my research because they generate a very particular series of events. The first one is a stretch reflex, like a tendon tap to the knee. The muscle is stretched and a feedback response counters the stretch. This response is mediated by the spinal cord and takes about 20 milliseconds for upper limb muscles. It depends on the amplitude of the stretch as well as on the state of the spinal cord at the perturbation. At around 60 milliseconds, we start to see the influence of cortex. At this time, neural signals have traveled through a distributed network of brain regions, and thus, the muscle activity at this time reflects the contribution of these regions. These responses are called long latency reflexes, and are generally more complex, owing to the more complex neural substrates. Voluntary responses typically are observed after about 100 milliseconds. Thus, by looking at the timing and at the amplitude of muscle activity following perturbations, we gain information about the functions of the underlying circuits. And this pattern is widespread in the motor system. When you do eye movements towards visual stimuli or even during eye-hand coordinations, perturbations elicit very rapid but automatic responses, which are reflexes, followed by more sophisticated responses supported by a more complex neural network. Looking at motor behavior in light of knowledge of the anatomy tells us what the brain does. In my research, we have demonstrated that many functions which are traditionally viewed as high-level or cognitive functions are also expressed in long-latency responses. It includes adaptation and learning. It includes weighting sensory information with prior knowledge. It also even supports rapid decisions about where to go or how to move. Everything happens in the motor system in less than the blink of an eye. Our hope is to translate this research, for instance, into biorobotics applications where we look at the behavior of animals to design robots, but also to clinical research. If we understand sensory motor processing in the brain, we can better identify the root cause of sensory motor deficits following brain injuries. We can also use this research to design neuroprosthetics in order to restore fully functional artificial limbs to amputees. If you want to know more about these projects and other research activities within ICT, do not hesitate to contact me.